Hello, my loves. This picture was at TJ Maxx a few weeks ago, and I really liked it. So as you can see, I snapped a picture of it, and I'm going to interpret my own version of that. What I liked about the picture is that each of the petals had its own flair, its own flavor, its own color scheme, and that's what I really dug about it. So that's what I'm going to interpret here today. While I do that with these alcohol inks that I made, I'll link that for you up in the little thingy. While I work on this flower, I've not been here for a little bit. Let me tell you why. First, I caught a cold again, and I just decided after what I'd been through this winter, I wasn't going to take any chances. I was going to keep my butt in bed and let myself rest and eat healthy food and sleep and sleep and sleep. And that's what I did. Not completely healthy food, though. I'm on this Kix kick right now, the cereal. But it doesn't have a lot of sugar, so I don't feel too bad about it, right? There was a Butterfinger thing for a minute. I got a little fat. I'm working that off. So anyway, back to why I'm not here. I also, if you have been here on the channel for a while, you may know I am also bipolar. And that kind of kicked in after I caught that cold. And I think it might have triggered it actually, because after being sick for so long, getting sick again just really, it knocked my feet out from underneath me emotionally. So, and I still have a tiny bit of a cough, so I'm sorry about that. Excuse me. So there we go. That's it. Nothing too crazy. Just I took the time. I needed the time. And when you take a break from your channel, even if it's a short one, sometimes coming back can be a bit of a struggle, right? Like you're working through some stuff. So that's all it was, guys. That's all. I'm back now. So enjoy videos, right? I enjoy making videos, so I hope you enjoy watching videos. So now I'm just doing the outline, and what I'm really doing is just really, really light, right? Just really light. I did put a matte top coat on top of these so that we would protect what's underneath the prettiness that I created, which right now I think looks kind of like a hodgepodge mishmash. But once we get it all done, I think it works. So I'm just lightly outlining it. That way, if there's anything I want to take off, it doesn't stain too much, because some matte top coats really accept a lot of color and they don't like to let it go. So this top coat, this matte top coat, is one of them. And while we're talking about that, I have revised my opinion on Gelixir as a base coat, top coat, matte top coat situation. I had never used their matte top coat, and I had been loving their regular stuff for doing, videos, the regular top coat. And so I went on ahead and bought it, and I have not liked it at all. First of all, it's so yellow. And I know that a lot of matte top coats, most matte top coats, have got a kind of a tinge of yellow to them. But this one, you might as well just call it yellow polish, because it's very yellow. So if you put it on anything that doesn't have a yellow undertone, it doesn't look that great. So I don't like that. It also stinks like really bad. So, not like as bad as varnish or acetone, but really bad. And it's a distinctive, oh, I opened the matte top coat smell. So whew, it was bad. So now that I've done the outline, we're going to come in with some silver and just create some little lines coming through, some little details. And I have worn the Gelixir now on my right hand. And it's soft. It's so, so, so soft. Softer than any top coat I've ever worn, except maybe Enel Couture. And I didn't like it. Things stick to it. It's not smooth all the time. It feels, it's not quite tacky, but kind of like silicone feels, right? Like you think it's tacky, but it's just sort of grabbing you. I don't know. I don't enjoy wearing it. And so those two things, between the matte top coat being so yellow and stinky, and the way that the shiny top coat performs, I'm going to have to say I'm off the Gelixir train. Now, as far as their color polishes go, I really like them. And you're always going to be top coating those. So that softness, maybe you're not going to notice. And I didn't notice any softness in the way that it feels when I'm playing with it. So, but you know what? I didn't notice that until I wore the top coat either. So, but I have worn a lot of the Gelixir polish underneath other top coat and have not had any trouble with it. So, now I'm just going to top coat these two because we're going to, as you can see, I've got some gems over there and we're going to put gems in the middle, just like the picture of the wall art had. And, but I'm going to pop these in the lamp first real quick. And there we go. Now we're going to top coat this. If I were going to add more gems, I would have used some actual, you know, builder gel or gem juice or whatever, but we're not. We're just putting a little middle to our flower, and it'll hold just fine, and nobody's wearing these nails. So I just don't see any point in wasting the product if I don't need to. But if you're going to be wearing something like this, I would definitely recommend something stronger than top coat. If you were going to wear a set like this, I would just recommend you pick one of the colors and paint the other two nails something really pretty, and then add a bunch of gems on there to really bling out the set. And then you'd be done. But this is the finished flower. Let me know what you think of it in the comment section below. Do you think I represented the wall art pretty well, or should I just keep trying? You let me know in the comment section below. We're going to see you next week for some more awesome videos. Mwah! Bye-bye.